The Making of a CEO by Sandeep K. Krishnan, narrated by Rajiv Dadia. Introduction. The Chief Executive Officer, that is CEO, epitomizes the organization. The organization's existence and its future are defined by the role the CEO plays. The CEO is the ultimate decision maker and can often be defined as a combination of a chief operations, marketing, finance, people, and communications officer, apart from the other key roles. The success or failure of the organization is often directly attributed to the CEO. At one level, the CEO is also the chief decision officer. Great CEOs leave their footprints behind. They have the ability to transform businesses and even change the way society operates. Bill Gates changed the way the world works with Microsoft. Steve Jobs changed the way the world designs gadgets with Apple. N.R. Narayana Murthy of Infosys paved the way and showed how corporations can share their wealth with employees in India. Dhirubhai Ambani, founder of Reliance, showed how an entrepreneur can start from scratch to create an empire. Larry Page and Sergey Brin, co-founders of Google, changed the way the world searches for information. It is amply clear that every CEO has a unique opportunity to leave behind an enduring legacy. In this book, the word CEO is sometimes used synonymously with positions such as managing director and chairman if the incumbent is also, in many ways, handling the operating role of running the company. Research shows that the role of a CEO is becoming more significant and often has a more direct impact on the company's performance. With the environment of organizations becoming more dynamic and competitive, it is the top management strategy led by the CEO that can steer the company towards sustained growth. A CEO also shapes the culture of the organization, either sustaining or changing it. An interesting example of this would be of the ex-chairman of IBM, Louis V. Gerstner, who is credited for its turnaround. Gerstner revived the ailing IBM by pulling the levers of its culture, changing the attitude towards teamwork, providing solution to the customers, integrating different business units, changing the measurement of results, and improving communication with external and internal stakeholders. In the end, it is a well-known fact that Gerstner got IBM to dance. There are leaders in corporates, NGOs, government and public sectors who have made a tremendous impact. There are great examples of public servants heading government enterprises and making a lasting impact on society. In India, E. Sridharan illustrated how a government servant can influence society by high levels of effectiveness. He is credited with the successful execution of key projects that helped the Indian public. This includes the Konkan Railway, a 741-kilometer line that connected Mumbai to Mangaluru. As per Wikipedia, with a total number of over 2,000 bridges and 91 tunnels to be built through this mountainous terrain containing many rivers, it was the biggest and perhaps the most difficult railway engineering project in the Indian subcontinent at the time. He was then entrusted with another key project to develop the metro lines for urban transport in the National Capital Region, that is NCR, called the Delhi Metro. The success of the project gave E. Sridharan a new name, Metro Man. The ability to lead and make a difference in the society has made E. Sridharan one of the most successful CEOs that India has seen in the recent past. Varghese Kurien, known as the father of the White Revolution, made a tremendous mark on the cooperative movement in the country. He is credited with establishing Amul and the National Dairy Development Board, that is NDDB. Kurien was able to bring dairy farmers into the fold, changing the dairy supply chain of the country. His ability to organize the cooperative movement, first in Gujarat through Amul and then later to replicate the experiment across the country through NDDB, points to a leader who could articulate a vision and execute it to make a large-scale institution. CEOs play the most critical role in organizational success. The making of a CEO is definitely not an easy journey. Data shows that in the past two decades, 30% of Fortune 500 CEOs have lasted less than 3 years. Top executive failure rates have been high, as high as 75% and not less than 30%. And the average tenure has been reducing over a period, that is, 9.5 to 7.6 years. According to the Harvard Business Review, 2 out of 5 new CEOs fail in their first 18 months on the job. This book attempts to understand how individuals evolve as great CEOs. The book synthesizes an understanding of how individuals develop skills and experiences for the role. The context of operations also illustrates how the role of a CEO is defined. The book covers the nuances of leading established organizations, family-owned enterprises, educational institutions, government and public sector enterprises, not-for-profit organizations, and startup firms. With the growth of the startup culture, we have witnessed professionals taking up the role of a founder CEO very early in their career, busting the usual image of CEOs who are in their late 40s or early 50s with a track record of broad exposure within one or multiple organizations. The book explores the journey of startup CEOs and some of the key expectations from the individuals in the role. A major part of the corporate world and the economy is controlled by family-owned businesses, CEOs who are part of the family, and professional CEOs who have been recruited from outside face different kinds of challenges. It is interesting to see how they rise to meet the expectations of different stakeholders. Our educational institutions play a key role in building society. Leading these institutions is a complex role with the administrative and academic aspects associated with it. The vice chancellors or principals of institutions play a role similar to that of a CEO of a business enterprise, but with a wider set of stakeholders to manage. Similarly, non-governmental organizations, that is, NGOs, try to create social change and are driven by their core purpose. Their CEOs have to balance the purpose and the business side of running such an organization. They also lead a unique set of employees who may not fit into the norms of a corporate entity. Finally, the book gives the reader an understanding of how professionals grow to take up the role of a CEO and how CEOs can improve their effectiveness by improving their skills. The premise of a lot of leadership theories and their effectiveness gets measured in terms of its applicability to a CEO. In an organizational context, the CEO becomes the ultimate leader and he or she can influence the organizational performance and employee outcome. For example, the leadership style of a CEO could influence the company's performance and also the employee's emotional relationship with the organization. Authority and power exercised by the CEO can also have substantial influence on the strategic direction of the company. Their role influences almost all of the critical functions of an organization. The job description below will give you an understanding of a CEO's role and will help you explore the key responsibilities that the incumbent handles. A brief overview of the role. A CEO is the highest-ranking executive in a company. The position is expected to drive the company's strategy and direction, be the liaison between company operations and the board of directors, manage the overall operations of the company, manage resources of the company, and ensure long-term success. Key responsibilities of the role. 1. Developing and implementing the company's strategy. 2. Ensuring corporate governance principles are followed. Be a role model for sustaining the organizational culture and values. 3. Develop the strategy for key divisions and functions and lead the top team of the company. 4. Work in close liaison with the board of directors. Be a trusted advisor to the board and align the company's operations with the broad direction set by the board. 5. Enhance the overall value of the firm for the shareholders by developing and implementing strategies that will improve growth, fundraising, acquisitions, and geographical expansion. 6. Creating and implement plans to fulfill the company's strategy. 7. Review the plans set by various divisions and functions and ensure that corrective actions are taken to meet agreed outcomes. 8. Achieve business growth by ensuring customer success. 9. Be the face of the company to the media and key industry or professional forums. 10. Attract, develop, and engage with key talent of the organization. Build and sustain a strong top team. The job description provides an overall view of the complexity of the role. The CEO plays the role of a primary strategist, moral compass, talent developer, sustainability officer, profit and loss manager, and finally, the spokesperson of the company. At the end of the day, the CEO should be able to create value for the customers, shareholders, employees, and society at large. It certainly is lonely at the top. The CEO should be able to drive the operations of the organization and, at the same time, play the role of a governance officer, ensuring compliance to the laws of the company. A CEO has tremendous responsibilities and expectations from multiple fronts. Let us take the example of Vishal Sikka, who was the first non-founder CEO of Infosys. His appointment attracted huge media attention and comments from multiple sources. The board and the founders were expecting him to bring in new strategies and help the company grow further. It was definitely a humongous task to bring change in an organization the size of Infosys with its legacy of being led by founders. Vishal Sikka, in an interview at the Wharton School, explained how he had brought about a new culture in the past 3 years, from 2014 to 2017. He revisited the go-to-market strategy, customer relationship management, culture of innovation at the workplace, and the structure and roles of the employees. Perspective of a seemingly positive stint, he had to resign from Infosys mainly because of his differences with one of the founders, Narayana Murthy. Managing expectations and stakeholders becomes an important factor for CEOs of such large organizations. However, it is also interesting to note how an outsider takes up a key role and delivers by bringing about changes to show positive results. One of the most critical questions to answer is, can one prepare oneself to become a CEO? Established organizations put in elaborate processes to find successors to CXOs and other senior management. IBM is a classic example where they have an elaborate process to groom leaders for the top slot. From a systems engineer in 1981 at IBM, Virginia Romiti grew to become its CEO in 2011 and then the CEO and chairman in 2012. She held many positions in the company and demonstrated her ability to lead multiple functions and businesses before finally.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.